Hi, welcome to another edition of Tech Topics. My name is Al Harper and I'm an SRE here in RTP, North Carolina. And today we're going to be talking about protection domains and how you can use them to back up information on your cluster. As we go through the demo, we'll be showing you various terms, so keep an eye out for those. Our demo today will use NOS version 4.0.2.1, though any of the information we talk about is applicable to any of the NOS 4.x versions. If you're using 3.5.x, please note that the information should still be applicable, it just may look a little different for you. All right, let's jump right into the demo. So let's take a look at protection domains in Prism. We'll navigate from the home page in Prism to data protection, and then from here we'll see our protection domains listed in the table. When we click on PD1, that's the name of our protection domain in this demo, we can see the details down in the bottom left, including the name, the mode, it's active, meaning that VMs are currently powered on, and the next snapshot time and the number of VMs. When we click over here on the right, we can see how many VMs are listed and what they are. We can unprotect them, and note that if you unprotect a VM from a protection domain, it doesn't delete the VM. All it does is tells it in the future not to back up any more VMs. This will also leave the snapshots there for that VM, so it's not going to delete anything. It just takes care of things going forward. When we click on schedules, we can see the schedules associated with it, as well as the retention policy for each schedule. Local snapshots will show our time stream with our most recent snapshot listed here at the top. Remote snapshots we won't really use here, neither will we use metrics since those are associated with a remote site. Alerts are going to be any alerts that are specific to protection domains, and the events is just an event log for everything that you've done and a timestamp associated with it. So let's go through and create a new protection domain to see what that looks like. We click on the plus protection domain at the top and then we can name it. We'll name it PD2. And then we can add virtual machines to it. From here, we'll just check the box for the VM that we'd like to add to the protection domain. We're going to leave it in a consistency group named after the VM, since that's not important to us. An application consistent snapshot will invoke VSS to get us a snapshot with the RAM dumped out to it. We don't need that, so we're not going to check it. We click protect, which adds it over here as a protected VM, and now we can click next. From here, we can create a schedule for it. You can set it up as minutely, hourly, daily, weekly, or monthly. Select a start time and an end time. We're going to have it start right now, and we will just have it continue indefinitely. Let's set it up to repeat every 1 hour and keep 3 snapshots. And it's important to remember how the retention policy affects the schedule. So all this means is that we have every VM we have the VMs backed up every hour, and we're holding on to 3 of them, meaning that they will have an expiry time of 3 hours from the time that they are created. This doesn't mean that we're going to delete snapshots when they're done. It simply means that after 3 hours, when we come onto that next one, the oldest one will be marked for expiration. Curator will be the one to go in and remove that at a later time. So let's create the schedule and then close out of this. We can see that PD2 was created, and it looks like what we would expect to see down here. And if we look at local snapshots, we have one created instantly right now. And you'll notice we also have a restore button here. If you want to roll back your VM, you can do that through this process. You can choose the VM that you want to restore. We have 2 options here. We can restore the VM, which will erase what's currently there and rewrite it with the snapshot. So any information that was there at the time, this will put this in place. We also have the clone option. When we click clone, it's going to leave the VM Win71 there, and it will create an additional VM based off the snapshot that we're referencing. And it's important here, you do need to create a file path. So you would actually have a slash and then whatever you wanted to call it. So if we did Win7-1-clone and click OK, it will go ahead and create that restoration for us and clone it. So, all right, so now that we have that protection domain created, let's look really quickly at the retention policy for the schedule and something that we have called the minimum snapshot count. The minimum snapshot count is a hidden value that we don't show, and by default it is set to 5. What this means is that for this protection domain, we have this set up to back up every 1 hour and hold on to 3, which we can see that if we look here, the create time is 12:56. And the expiration time is 3:56. So that's 3 hours from now that that will be set to expire. As long as everything continues, we should build up a snapshot every hour, and so that expiration time is normal. However, outside of Prism, it is going to hold on to 5 snapshots by default just to make sure that everything's okay. That's just set up as a safety net. If you have a cluster that has any sort of space concerns and you're backing up large VMs, it's a good idea to go through and set your minimum snapshot value to be the same as your schedule. That way you don't have unnecessary snapshots taking up space. So we're going to be looking at this in NCLI in the NOS 4.0.2.1 code versions. So let's pop over to NCLI. We already have a session connected here, logged into one of our CVMs. Select connect to NCLI. We're going to flag dash H true, and this will actually show hidden commands for us. So now that we're connected, we can run the command pd set min snapshots. And then we want to say the name, and this would be the name of the protection domain. So we'll do pd2, and then we set the minimum snapshot value. And the minimum snapshot value by default is 5. So we're going to set this to 3 so that it lines up with the retention policy that we have set up in Prism. We run this, we get the following output: minimum snapshot for protection domain PD2 updated successfully. There's not a way to view what the minimum snapshot value is currently set to, but it's always safe to go in here and set it yourself. Note that if we did set the minimum snapshots to 2, since the retention policy is 3 and that's a greater value, it will hold on to 3. So this is just there as a safety net, but it's always something to keep in mind. All right, guys, well, thanks for tuning in. Everything that I've talked about here can be located in the product documentation guides, which are on portal.nutanix.com, and everything with protection domains is specifically in the web console guide. And be sure to check back for more tech topics.